Hello, my name is Nigel Palmer, and I'm the author of the book, The Regenerative Grower's Guide to Garden Amendments. In this short video, I'm going to show you how to make fermented fish. Getting the fish is a big part of the process. In this particular case, my brother-in-law was fishing in the Atlantic Ocean, and they use mackerel for bait, and there's always mackerel left over. So he brings it to me knowing that I would like to put it in my garden. So I give great thanks to not only my brother-in-law for providing me the fish, but also for the fish themselves. What a beautiful, beautiful resource. These mackerel are very nice. They're a blue oily fish and are loaded with all kind of lovely enzymes and oils and things that the garden will love. So once you've given thanks for this lovely gift, the next thing is to measure things up. Make sure you have the right amount of organic brown sugar to accommodate the amount of fish you have, and make sure that you have a container that's big enough to accommodate all of this. So this video shows how to cut up the fish and mix it. In this case, I cut up the fish and mixed it in a crock and then poured it all into a big bowl and mixed it all together, and then finally put a top layer of fish and sugar. Once you have this crock full of fish and organic brown sugar, the next thing to do is to cover it and store it. It needs to be stored in a dry, well-ventilated area out of sunlight. In this particular state, it will smell for a while before it settles in, if you will. The odors can be eliminated or greatly reduced, even changed, by adding IMO4 onto the top. Okay. Let's see, fermented fish. So what we're going to do is first give thanks for the fish that are here. Thank you very much for the fish and the opportunity to get them. My brother-in-law was fishing in the ocean, and the mackerel is used as bait, and he knows that I'm interested in mackerel for the garden, and so this is how I got these fish today, and I thank the fish and Mike for providing them to me. And we'll cut the fish up into chunks. We're going to use all parts of the fish, and we'll cut them in chunks and then layer them into the crock. All right, I've got everything I need. I've got a scale to measure the fish and the brown sugar. I've got a lot of brown sugar here, and I've got three crocks of various sizes to put the fermented fish in as I go along. So the next step is to weigh out the ingredients, the fish and the brown sugar, so that I know that I have enough. And here are some mackerel that are ready to go. And so I'm going to weigh these. So I'm at about 2.5 pounds. So that's 12, 13 pounds minus 2.5. That's about 10.5 pounds of fish. So I'm going to need 10.5 pounds of sugar to accommodate this bag. And that looks like it'll pretty well fill up that 3-gallon crock. So there's a good starting place. So next I have to measure out 10.5 pounds of sugar to mix in with the fish as I cut it up and mix it and put it in the crock. So that's 10 pounds. That bowl pretty well full is 4.5 minus 10. That's about 5.5 pounds. So if I fill that bowl up a second time, then I'll be using a ratio of 1:1 fish and brown sugar. So now I have a gauge of how much sugar I add just to get to that 1:1 ratio. So I've set up myself a little production line here. I've got a bench that is nothing more than a piece of wood on some cinder blocks, and I've tried to level these out so that the table sits flush on the cinder blocks. And I did that by merely setting the cinder blocks, by picking them up and setting them down firmly on the ground. That
gets things pretty flush. And so my fish will be here. I will cut them up. I'll put them in the crock. I'll add sugar and we'll fill up the crock and see how we go. I know I have 10 pounds of fish in this one bag. And I have 5 pounds of sugar here, so I'll need 2 bowls of sugar. My 10 pounds of mackerel, and give thank you for the mackerel that have provided me with this opportunity to make this amazing amendment. Nice sharp knife helps. Sprinkle the bottom with sugar. Add fish. So to promote good mixing, I dumped the whole crock into the bowl and I'm mixing it up to make sure that sugar is nice and throughout. Good mixing. And then adding the balance of the sugar. I want to make sure I get that 1-to-1 ratio between sugar and that final layer of fish on the top. There we go. And then sugar. Flies have moved in, so it's a good time to clean up. So I've got a nice layer of sugar on the top of that. It's a little bit more than 3/4 full, but there's airspace and it'll be lightly covered inside, so that'll be okay. So the next thing I want to do is clean all this up, and then I've got to figure out what to do with the rest of the fish. Once the crock is full of fish and brown sugar and there's a layer on the top, it can be stored for some period of time with a cloth over it. It may begin to smell. If it does smell, look at it and make sure that the entire surface is covered with sugar. That will help reduce the smell. If you have some, you could get some IMO4 and take the IMO4 and put it on the top. Just sprinkle it on the top. And the biology in the IMO4 will eliminate the smell. Actually, the IMO4 smells very good. It's got that beautiful earthy smell. Nice. And then finally, we'll put a cloth over the top of this. And I use a string to just keep it, the cover, a little bit taut. There. And that's ready to go. And we'll store this in a dry, well-ventilated place out of sunlight. And if you don't like it in your living room, you could put it in a garden shed or in a garage where it's not going to be affected by other animals. Keep an eye on it. Check it out. And this will want to sit for 9 months or a year, 6 months at least, as it ferments away. Don't let it freeze. If you live in a cold climate and that garden shed's gonna go below freezing, you'll wanna bring it into a warmer environment. But after a period of time, the smell will definitely dissipate, even if you don't use the IMO4.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that video. I had 35 fish left over. I had a total of 70 fish to start with, and I had 35 left over. In the next video, I'll show you how to incorporate these fish directly into the compost pile without incurring any damage from animals that might stray by. We have a wild selection of animals here, from raccoons to fisher cats to bears, and on and on. And using these techniques, you can actually put the fish, whole fish, into the compost pile without worrying about the compost pile being destroyed. So stay tuned for that.